Welcome. We'll be covering a rapid round before your prelims on the major topics that you must be aware about. So, without wasting the time, let's start with our first part, that is history. Now, some of the major developments that we have seen in history. The first one is a stone sculpture has been identified in the region of Goa, and that belongs to the Paulist group of missionaries. Now, this Paulist group or the Pauline group are the name that denotes the Roman Catholic and those who follow the first hermit, that is the Paul of Thebes, and that is the sculpture which has been identified dating back to 16th and 17th century. Now, the next important development in the field of history we can say is Fort Emmanuel. Now, Fort Emmanuel is a fort which has been built on the laterite bricks. Now, laterite is a kind of clay soil which actually has a lot of moisture content in it, and this fort was built by Portuguese in 1503 and that was along the range of the Fort Kochi in Kerala, and this was later reinforced in 1538. Now, this fort, there have been numerous steps to conserve this fort since it has been on a laterite soil and it has been actually getting subsided. So, the ruins of it have been part of the Fort Kochi and therefore important. The next important development that we can see is the painting Indulekha. Now, Indulekha is one of the famous paintings by Raja Ravi Verma. Raja Ravi Verma has actually brought the first copy of this painting in the region of Kerala in the Kilamanur Palace, and this is one of the very unique paintings that has been cited. The next is Mumbai Central Station. Now, Mumbai Central Station, Maharashtra government has been talking about renaming it after Nana Jagannath Shankar Seth. He was one of the major social reformers who had played a very important role in shaping of Mumbai. So, works and developments about Nana Jagannath Shankar Seth is again important. The next development we can see is the Vaikom Satyagraha. Now, Vaikom Satyagraha, 100 years have passed for the Vaikom Satyagraha and therefore is in news. Now, this was the first anti-caste movement Satyagraha which was released across India, and mainly focusing on the restriction of the entry of depressed class from entering into temples in India, and therefore Vaikom Satyagraha has an important basis. 300 years have been celebrated for Rani Holkar, and the birth anniversary of Rani Holkar, the 300 years has been marked, and Ahilyabai Holkar and her development in and around the regions of Indore are again important. The next and the most important thing in history today that we would be discussing is Neanderthals. Now, Neanderthals is one of the evolutionary chains of human species. Now, recently it was in news because it was believed that the studies from the caves of Chagarasya have shown, this is in Russia, and this caves have shown, the findings from this cave has shown that Neanderthals suffered from three viruses. Now, these three viruses are important. The first one is the adenovirus that causes the cold and flu-like symptoms. The second one is the papillomavirus, and this causes cancers and genital warts. The third one is the herpes virus, and this causes cold sores, chicken pox, and mononucleosis and muconucleosis, and these three viruses were the viruses which infected Neanderthals, and these three viruses are also seen in the present time. So again, the developmental basis has been revealed. Also, Neanderthals are believed to be the closest relative to the human beings, and they are extinct. The fossils and the DNA have been seen from nearly 5 lakh years ago. So we can see how our ancestors had developed and grown. Also, how they actually separated into the European branch have been an important study. So evolutionary basis and the archaeological basis again becomes an important topic in this line. The next is some of the major developments in archaeological site in India. So one is the Rakhigiri. Rakhigiri lies in Haryana, and Rakhigiri is one of the regions where archaeological remains of nearly 8,000 years ago had been identified, and it was believed that the Aryan invasion happened somewhere between 1800 to 1500 years ago. And then there were American archaeologists and Egyptian archaeologists like Parekh who actually worked with ASI, that's the Archaeological Survey of India, talking about satellite archaeology or satellite remote sensing, and 90%, they identified that 90% of the real history or India's heritage is actually buried. So that was again an important development. The next is nearly 800 years old human remain settlement has been identified in Vadnagar in Gujarat. Now this is considered as the oldest living city within a fortification which was unearthed, and this was along with another city which was in Beni Sagar. Now Beni Sagar is actually another important region where we have seen it's close to Mayurbhanj in Odisha and the regions of Jharkhand, and this is the area where we have seen strong foundations with Hindu sculptures that have been identified. So temple complexes with images of Surya, Bhairav, Agni, Kuber and Lakulish have been seen in Beni Sagar. So again, Beni Sagar has been important. There has been also a stone seal with Chaturvidya indicating Priyangu as one of the seal shows a Chaturvidya which has been inscribed, and this is again important. Then the next one is Adopt a Heritage 2.0, and this is a scheme to safeguard the cultural heritage propounded by Archaeological Survey of India. So again, under archaeological, I would remind there are two major developments. One is the Vadnagar site in Gujarat, where we have seen the recent excavation of 800-year-old human fortification or fortified settlement that has been seen. Along with that, we have seen potteries, copper, gold, bangles which have been found, coins which have been found from Vadnagar. And then we have the Beni Sagar, which lies away from West Singhbhum in Jharkhand, bordering the regions of Odisha, Mayurbhanj district. And this has been again one of the major centers where human modules have been seen, where Hindu artifacts have been seen. So again, these are some of the important topics from history and archaeological purpose. We will be covering space in the next part, so stay tuned.